Whoa, video started. Yeah, that's not as good as I was hoping today. Ouch, I'm moving quicker. I'm standing more upright, but there's more pain, which is weird. But anyway, it doesn't matter. On to the video fun. So anyway, Nicotine Guy made a video on this whole moral ethics value subject. I have to come up with a better name for it. So I think morality is kind of a lost word. I said it before. It's got too much religious cooties on it to be of any use. So I think it's sort of an ethical thing. And ethics are just value, so why don't we just make it a value equation? Anyway, so he has maligned negative utilitarianism, minimizing losses being a first priority. The idea that you would first do no harm. Like, that's not somehow reasonable. What word did he use? Ouch. Ridiculous. It's ridiculous to assume the negative. Assume that life doesn't know what it's doing first, and then prove it otherwise, until proven otherwise. So, that's all I'm basically saying, is that the argument is, alright, life is a consuming and reproducing slop that has infested planet Earth. It's basically become cannibalistic over time, and it doesn't do much except build coral reefs and pyramids. You know, what else? What else have animals made besides coral? Let's see. There's probably some other feature. You know, well, forest. It makes forest. It makes the plant look all pretty from space. So, yeah, that's it, okay? So you want to tell me? And the price for that has been a bunch of nerve impulses have traveled down, traveled through nerve cells, and created sensations in about 2 gazillion organisms. And yes, they have had some fun. Little spurts of this or that have shot out of this or that. And they've gone, yeah, okay, there. Right, so we're supposed to go all gooey about that, and it'd be ridiculous to say, oh, that's a really dumb game. You know, you got all this blood and guts all over the fucking place, and all you did was coral, and you put some junk on the moon that no one will give a fuck about. What? Oh, you played a song. Yeah, that's it. What? There's no... So anyway, I don't think it's ridiculous to say, hey, if you're going to claim this is doing something spectacular besides eating its own ass, prove it, fucker. Okay? You're the one with the ridiculous claim. You're ridiculously claiming that this crap is accomplishing something. What was it accomplishing? A bunch of need. Well, this plant's going to kill that plant and suffocate it from any sunlight, and then this plant will, well, it'll reproduce itself and do the same thing to some other plant. Oh, how fucking cool is that? And let's talk about all the feeling organisms chopping each other to pieces. And all the little malicious disease organisms, the little mechanical, stupid microbe things that don't even know they're goddamn evil, don't even know they're part of a silly system, and they're just a little mechanical machine, designed to keep itself in existence, and they end up causing tremendous suffering. I mean, fuck you. Well, really, I mean, ridiculous. Yes, it's ridiculous to be an atheist and contemplate this from a blank slate. We must presume that nature knows what it's doing. The nature is God. The DNA. It's 3 letters. G-O-D. DNA. They both have 3 letters. Case is proven. Is that going to be your argument, Nick? So, ridiculous. I think you're going to have to do a lot better than ridiculous as an argument. So anyway, yes to the utilitarian approach. I mean, that's just obvious. I mean, to me. I mean, come on. You can't judge value any other way. You have to judge it for the how the whole fucking game runs. The whole game is the game. And then you can start worrying about individual players and all the rest of that crap. But the only question that ultimately matters, that matters first anyway, is first you gotta make the whole game make sense. Then you gotta make it fair to the players. And then you can worry about the stands and the fans and whatever. I mean, whatever the priority is. All right, but anyway, no more. Ew, there's a dead animal right here somewhere. Ew, fuck. Me and them equals game. That's not what I want. Oh, this other side has the nose that matter. God, I'm fucked up. My back's bad. My equilibrium's fucked. Anyway. Yeah, so let's talk about, you clearly said it. You said it's, not to think one pain is worth somebody else's gain. You basically said there's some notion of equality between satisfaction, like, I felt good. I'll just, there, that was worth having, malaria. I mean, you know, you have to quantify this crap. You can't just have this presumption that somehow the pain and the gain all works out in the end. You know, there has to be some sort of equation here. It has to be worked out. Some sort of value definition. Yes, humans have subjectively applied this definition. But they're part of the game. They're part of the addiction. You don't ask a heroin addict to evaluate, you know, heroin. It's stupid. You know. So we have to step out of our own addiction. You know, what we think is valuable, subjectively, and attempt to rationally evaluate the scenario. And I'm saying if you do that, if you really apply hard intelligence to the question, you'll be able to see the character difference between pain and gain, between what we call gain. That we are basically designed to be unsatisfied, to keep us motivated to push, to get more, to keep moving, to keep feeding, and you know, and that most of our satisfaction can have a almost minuscule a length of satisfaction time. I mean, it runs out so quickly; it's very brief, and our miseries can be they can last for hours and days and lifetimes. You know. And that's the truth of it. So you can't just sit there and put an equal sign and say there, problem's resolved. No, we haven't resolved that equation yet. There's lots of context to be applied to make sense of that. So, yeah, that's probably enough. I mean, the real argument's going to be is about just how silly is most of our need. Most of the crap we're chasing, you know, we can, and just how much can we reduce the equation? How simple can we make what pleases us? You know, make the satisfying meal illusion take place with the fewest ingredients, the meagerest gruel for the highest maximized satisfaction, and the obvious shitbag human being would be one of these eccentric assholes who basically almost needs to eat other people to have a satisfying meal. You know, I mean, they are so eccentric in what they need to avoid despondency or depression, you know, that they're just so inefficient in acquiring their satisfaction that, yeah, their life is fail all over the place. But even the meager human being still living in this shit game, and it's really hard to extract your bit of comfort without stepping on a lot of shit, stepping into a lot of shit in terms of even your own mechanisms of desire. Because if I give you what you want today, you're probably going to want some more tomorrow, and that's a real problem that's built into our psychology. So anyway, generally speaking, good video, but, you know, unfair to whatever, negative utilitarianism. Really, I'm not. If you can show me a gain that's, you know, in substance really worth a pain, fine. If you can show me a gain that's built out of something but addiction, then fine. I don't mind being just a utilitarian, you know. But the real game is preventing suffering. Suffering has the mass. It has the real weight. It's a solid, substantive thing. If we can get the hell out of the game, that's damn progress for sure. And it's, you know, you could just stop right there and just go with the progress part. But I will argue, as the ultimate truth will be, that the game can't be played. It's a bad game. Consumption, reproduction. Just can't go anywhere. You can't make anything good out of it. So anyway, till next time.